Good morning, everyone. I am here with Pranavi and Pawan Kumar, sir. So we are going to have a discussion about sir's experience in the pharmaceutical industry as part of our career guidance project. So we've been assigned to the pharma industry, and we'll be asking sir a few questions about his experiences so that we can get a better understanding.
Definitely, definitely. Proceed.
So,
Pranavi, yes, sir. So, please tell two few lines about yourself.
See, myself, Pawan Kumar Nisankara Rao. I'm working as a vice president, business development in pharma, API marketing. So, I am responsible for US and Europe markets, which we call them as a regulatory markets, higher end markets. So I'm with currently Metrochem API Private Limited, so which is a 1,000 crores turnover company. Last year we touched 2,000 crores. We do have a aim of, you know, next 5 years we want to be there in 3,000 crores company. I'm purely responsible for the developing the business into US and Europe markets, supplying API to the US and Europe markets.
Okay, sir. So what overall,
Overall, I have 18 years of experience in pharma industry, but I'm a different background. I came from a different background. I'm from a, you know, computer graduate. So moved to pharma industry. I feel proud to be a pharma industry guy, because if you see in the pandemic situation also, there are so many constraints which faced by every industry except pharma. So as and when the people are there in the world, on the earth, they need to take medicine. So definitely, I obviously choose, even my entire family. I'm just keeping each and every person for a different department in pharma industry. So my son, Giridhar, also I recently chosen a BSc chemistry. Then MSc chemistry and MBA marketing. So for his career path, you know, I designed for only pharma industry, with respect to the pharma industry. So I strongly believe this profession will be evergreen.
Okay, sir. Thank you. So,
what are your strengths and weaknesses?
My strength. So my strength, I'm the best person to listen to my customer. I'm the best person to understand my customer. I'm the best person to justify or take a decision towards my customer satisfaction. So my weakness, I can say, maybe I am a little worried about, you know, when people are unable to listen to me. Then I may get frustrated, you know, if I am unable to spell out, sometimes, you know, I get some headaches, that kind of thing. That's all, nothing else. You know, I'm in all the respects, I'm a team player, I'm a leader, I go with, any decision or any advice, given by any person also, I consider it in a logical manner, or any decision should be justified with a logic. That's what I believe.
Sir, so what is your work? Like, what's your role in your company, and what do you do in your everyday work? Could you tell us about that?
See, I told you about my profile. I'm responsible for, you know, offering my product to the US market and Europe market. We sell the API, bulk drug. So it's API means active pharma ingredient, which controls your disease. Okay, API is of active pharma ingredient. You know, some people they may call it like a bulk drugs. The technical people, they name it as a API, active pharma ingredient, which cures your disease. So this product we sell to the companies who makes the formulations. Formulations means who makes the tablet or injection or capsule ointment. So who makes the finished formulation? We sell the product to the companies who make the formulations. As I mentioned, you formulations means it may be a tablet or a capsule or injection or ointment in any kind of format. So this major my responsibility, which I sell the API to customers located in US and Europe.
Sir, so did anybody inspire you to go into the pharmaceutical industry, or was it your own interest? Could you tell us about that?
No. My brother was my inspiration because I saw a lot of benefits, working in pharma industry. By choosing the pharma industry, my brother was the inspiration. And by choosing this profession, especially into marketing, I'm into business development. This was advised by one of my ex-colleague. He saw me a lot of convincing skills in me. So he advised to go for a marketing, because I'm not a marketing guy. But after that, I did an MBA from Gautam University, Open University. Because of somebody was advised by looking at me, or by, the way I convince a customer. So he advised me to, come into the business development segment. So that's how I have chosen. And my role model, my guru, Mr. Krishna Reddy, is also having one of the, he worked with Dr. Reddy's more than 30 years, and then 10 years with MSN Laboratories Private Limited. And now he started his own company, Rui Laboratories Private Limited. Plant is located in Vizag, and office is located in Vasanthanagar only. He is my real guru. I learned so many things from him. How to promote the product, how to service the customer, how to negotiate, how to convince. So I can say my guru is Mr. Krishna Reddy, in especially in business development activities.
Okay, sir. So what are the challenges that you faced in this industry, and what are the challenges that usually everyone faces who comes to the pharmaceutical industry?
See, any industry is a challenging. Every day is a challenging, because anybody. See, when you gain, every day is a learning day for us. Every day is a challenging for us. We need to overcome those criticalities and keep that into the memory. You need to grow. When you are growing, your memory should be, that is also should grow. So every day is a learning day. When the problem comes, we need to solve that problem. Then we will feel, so happy to, overcome that problem. That's where without any problem, there will not be a life. So we should learn from the problems. But the problem cannot be repeated. The same problem cannot be repeated. So we create a system such a way for the problem. We give you a solution, but that solution should not create another problem.
Yes, so
that's how we move on.
So why do you like this career, and were you able to fulfill your goals?
See, first of all, any education or any qualification is meant for to earn the money. Okay, I'm very much satisfied of the package which I'm getting here. I'm very happy to say this. If I could have in a different profession, might be I'm not at this level. So I'm very much satisfied with my work, and I'm very much satisfied with my profile. Professionally and personally, I'm very happy because of I have chosen the pharma industry.
Sir, so what are the specific things that you like in this career, which you think you won't find anywhere else?
It's not like that. I moved, first initially when I joined in MSN Laboratories Private Limited, I started my career as an executive by taking care of logistics, material moving from plant to the customer locations, from Hyderabad to different places in the world. So I'm the in charge of logistics guy. So then moved to Mumbai. I used to take care of entire Mumbai region customers. Then my wing was expanded to even Ahmedabad. Then I came back to Hyderabad and I took the entire Pan India business. See, we cannot learn the things in a single day. We cannot handle the business, the entire country business in a single day. We need to go stepwise. So that's how I moved into the stepwise. Then I came back to Hyderabad. I took the Pan India business. I'm the head of Pan India business. Then along with this, I took one more charge of, handling of Algeria, Morocco, Tunisia markets. So once, every year when I'm moving on, I'm taking the responsibilities to learn more and more and more on year on year. And then in addition to that, I took PPIC planning and all. So every year I'm taking the responsibility from the organization. I'm learning. So every day is a learning day for me, even still today.
Yes, sir. It's very nice to hear about the things you have achieved throughout your career. So I would like to get into some technical aspects. Sir, could you tell us about some entry requirements for this profession? Like, which qualifications do we need? Like in plus one and plus two, what do we need to study? And then bachelor's degree, do we study BSc or B Pharma? Or yes.
See, when you want to enter into the pharmaceuticals, the formulations, as I mentioned you, who makes the tablets and the capsules and all, that company requires B Pharmacy and M Pharmacy guys. Those companies. Hardly in Hyderabad, if you name it, Dr. Reddy, Sarabindo, Natco, Hetro, Mylan. On fingers, you can say 10-15 companies are there in Hyderabad, especially. Formulation companies who makes, finished formulations. What we call them as a formulations, finished formulations. But Hyderabad industry is morely occupied with the bulk drug industry. That is, as I told you, it is an API, active pharmaceutical ingredients. Bulk drug industry. So for this industry, BSc chemistry, MSc chemistry, MBA, coming into the market, MBA is required. Otherwise, technical aspects, you can move on to the BSc chemistry and MSc chemistry. And if you go with BTech chemical engineering, so coming to the only bulk drug industry requires, BSc chemistry, MSc chemistry graduates. There is a department called PED, Process Engineering Department. That department requires BTech Chemical Engineering. So when you do BTech Chemical Engineering, only one department can able to take you for that position. But if you do BSc Chemistry or MSc Chemistry, there are so many departments like QC, QA, Regulatory Affairs, Developmental QA, R&D, AR and analytical R&D, research and development, any department you are going to suitable for any of the department which I mentioned you right now. But if you go for a BTech chemical engineering, you are meant for only PED, process engineering department.
Okay, sir. So I would like to know, is there any biology also involved in any of the careers?
Very biology, and see, those technologies are not there in India, especially biotechnology, biochemistry. It may take some time to go with flow chemistry. There are some other techniques are coming, but those are very niche, very rare, very niche and very rare. But we need to look at the broad prospect to where we can able to move our career in a different departments. I strongly suggest to go with, BSc chemistry and MSc chemistry. If you want to work in bulk drug industry, API industry. So if you want to work in formulations, so B Pharmacy, M Pharmacy, I prefer it. So if you want to go with BTech chemical engineering, you need to go with the bulk drug industry, but you are more restricted to the one department, that is PED.
Okay, yes, sir. I was asking this because my favorite subject is chemistry and I would like to pursue a career in that. That's why I wanted to.
Excellent. Excellent. Excellent choice taken by you, definitely your decision is wise decision, good decision, right decision.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. So the next one is, what do you recommend to aspiring pharmacists, chemists, and druggists? Would you recommend this profession at all?
100%. I do recommend. No, I told you in the initial conversation itself, the best profession to select.
Yes, sir. So, what are the core competencies, like which skills and not only like core subjects, any other subject strengths which are required? So, what are the core competencies which you need for this profession?
See, when it comes to the profession, the other you will get to know the in detailed. But your core subject, 80% of the subject is chemistry only. See, other than that, you know, communication skills, presentation skills. So those are additional things which your language skills. So that's enough to move on with this profession.
Yes, sir. Yes, you're sir. Also telling about your ability to convince customers very well. So I think maybe that's also very important.
In detail, if you go, a lot of things things will come into picture.
Yes, sir. So what are the different specializations and branches in pharma? In the pharma industry.
So, like, you know, you want to know what are the departments which they do in bulk drug industry, API industry, or what is it? Like, see, there are so many departments are there. There are service departments, technical departments, commercial departments. Like, if you go to the plant manufacturing side, starts with production, stores, production, manufacturing. Production means manufacturing, quality control, quality assurance, and regulatory affairs. Process engineering department. These are the departments, you know, established in the manufacturing site. So if you come to the office side, HR, admin, accounts, business development or marketing, management. So they sit in the corporate segment.
So could you tell us more about the science specific segment of the company, the people who are testing the drugs, the people who are manufacturing? So if you have any awareness about that, could you tell us?
It's their regular job. Manufacturing person will do the manufacturing, QC person, they do the analysis. So once they join, they start their career with executive or trainee. From that level, executive to the senior executive, junior manager, assistant manager, deputy manager, manager, senior manager, assistant general manager, DGM, GM, senior GM, VP, associate VP, VP, president, senior VP, president. So that will be, these are the, designations, allocated in the pharma industry. So if you choose any department in the pharma, your career starts with training, then executive like this, the flow which I told you. In detail, their work profiles are, predefined, what to do in their work.
Sir, so in India and in foreign countries, what are the best work destinations for this career? For example, Hyderabad itself, you have told around 10-15 names. So could you tell some very good concentrated areas where pharma industry is blooming?
Yeah, other than Hyderabad, in Andhra Pradesh, Vizag is the place, for the manufacturing sites. In Ankaleshwar, Gujarat, Mumbai. So these are the places majorly pharma industry established in India.
Sir, in foreign countries?
So those are, each and every country, they have their pharma industry. There are a few countries which they don't know for the anti-cancer drugs, Bangladesh doesn't make any product. They buy from India only. But they have other APIs. And Russia, they don't have any manufacturing, API manufacturing. They have finished formulations. But they don't make bulk drugs. They buy bulk drugs from India and they make the tablets in Russia. So US, you have a number of choices. In Europe, you have a number of choices. It's more specific to the country to the country. I cannot describe in a small word. Your question is very big, but I cannot describe in a small sentence. It depends on the country to country.
Sir, what are the guidelines that the pharma industry follows? Like when somebody sets up a pharma company, are there any guidelines or basic knowledge that they follow?
Yes, exactly. A lot of guidelines are there, you know, ICH guidelines, Q7 guidelines, GMP guidelines, US FDA authority guidelines, EDQM guidelines. So there are so many guidelines are there. So with respect to the, each country have their own guidelines. When we want to enter into that market, we need to know those guidelines. According to, we need to move on. So each and every country have their own guidelines. Japan, yes, is having different. Korea is having different. China is having different now.
Yes, sir. So what are the latest tech advancements that took place in the pharma industry?
Technology wise, you know, now people are talking about flow chemistry. So with less equipment to get more output, like to make the big tonnage of volumes, you require a lot of place, manpower resources. But you know, now people are, you know, if it is a regular product, they want to make it in a very small item with a big output. So that is called, I think in my terminology, with the people started working on it, it's flow chemistry.
Sir, what are the long-term career prospects for people who take up this career? Like, what can they expect in a few years? Let's say the startup at a certain role, like where can they rise to after they stay in a certain place for a few years?
See, it depends on each and every individual. So based on your knowledge, your skills, work atmosphere, and it's all together how you perform. So people will go up to the certain levels and they stay at that level only because of their acceptance. Their listening and their acceptance is required, and adapting the new technologies, new methodologies. So it is purely, you know, one person, you know, comes with the 15 years of experience. They may go up to 1 crore, 2 crore, 3 crore salary. But people are having more than 30 years also, they may have 10 lakhs package only. Even 5 lakhs packages is also there because they are stagnant. They are not willing to take the new things into the brain. So it's purely an independent guy's. See, I will quote you one best example. I saw in the newspaper, in ISB, there was a campus selections happened. The same campus, same classroom. One guy got 1 crore package. The other least guy got 3 lakhs package. But the same classroom, same teacher, professor explained. But still, why the difference? Because it is purely based on their individual talent.
Okay, sir. So what does a pharmacist mean?
Pharmacist, pharmacist is, he can able to guide how what medicine to give. See, I'm not into purely technical guy to explain about that word. But for my understanding, pharmacist means, you know, he knows the drug, how to give and where to give. For which disease, for which drug is required, and maybe pharmacist can able to guide that.
Okay, so sir. So that's all for today, sir. Thank you so much for your time. You explained a very complex thing in very simple words. We were able to understand the overall
in a better way.
We understood about the different intricacies in a industry such as the pharmaceutical industry. So thank you so much for your time.
Welcome, sir. And also the departments, you explained about the different categories. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Welcome. Always welcome. Anytime.